My name is Aaron Lussier, research scientist in mineralogy here at the museum. Today, I'll show you some highlights of the newly acquired Gilles Hainaut Mont-Saint-Hilaire collection that I think best exemplify its cultural and scientific value. Gilles Hainaut, along with his late wife Liliane, had spent much of the last 40 years collecting mineral specimens at Mont-Saint-Hilaire. In fact, in 2004, he was honored with his very own mineral, hainautite, the small yellow crystals we see here. Beginning in the 1980s, Gilles was granted exclusive collecting access to the quarry. Recently, as he decided to part with his immense collection, he felt strongly that it remain in Canada, and after negotiating with the museum, it arrived in 2019. The collection consists of six annexes, separated based on specimen quality. The best specimens, the second best, excellent, pseudomorphs, systematic minerals, and research materials, totaling more than 8,000 individual pieces. In 2019, the Canadian Cultural Property Export Review Board designated approximately 1,000 of these specimens as being culturally significant treasures, placing them alongside famous artworks and other objects of historical significance. The scientific value of the collection is immeasurable. It will show us new mineral species, teach us about crystal chemistry, alkaline geology, and rare element geochemistry, and most critically, it will help train future generations of scientists and mineralogists. The specimen shown here contains a new mineral species, Alice Wilsonite, recently discovered at the museum by researcher Ina Lakova. Alice Wilson was the first female geologist hired by the Geological Survey of Canada. At Saint-Hilaire, common minerals are often observed with uncommon features. Quartz is usually clear, but these crystals of smoky quartz have an opaque prism face. And here, ilmenite occurs as a well-formed rosette of tabular crystals. Rhodochrosite is beloved by collectors. Crystals from Saint-Hilaire are known to show a wide range of crystal forms. And zircon often occurs in rocks as millimeter scale crystals, but the brown zircon here is nearly 2 centimeters across. Saint-Hilaire is famous for vibrant red sarandite crystals. Pectolite is also a common mineral. These two minerals actually have identical atomic structures, differing only in the amount of manganese and calcium that they contain. Saint-Hilaire is also famous for pseudomorphs, where one mineral is replaced by a new one, kind of like a fossil. This results in a new crystal having the form of the old crystal, and here black bernasite is a pseudomorph of sarandite. Often thought of as the centerpiece of the Hainaut-Saint-Hilaire collection, here we see a large rosette of nearly perfect translucent crystals of cataplayite. This specimen here is considered to be the best known example of the species. The rare mineral rhazvamite contains both potassium and chemically reduced sulfur, and Mont-Saint-Hilaire is known to produce some of the best known crystals of rhazvamite, which also include unusual amounts of rubidium and cesium. Shortite is a rare sodium calcium carbonate, occurring with both lemon yellow and lime green colors. This purple pseudolite, measuring on the order of 2.5 centimeters, is among the largest known in the world. Ramondite is a carbonate mineral containing rare earth elements. This very unique specimen shown here contains a ramondite core encrusted with calcioansalite. And rarely, ramondite can be faceted into a gemstone like we see here. Leafite and its potassium-bearing analog, ericite, are zeolite minerals. Saint-Hilaire is known for producing specimens that show a nearly perfect spherical form. These are actually aggregates of thousands of individual crystals. Natrolite is the most abundant zeolite mineral found at Mont-Saint-Hilaire. Imaged in the ultraviolet light, natrolite can display a vibrant green color. However, the exact cause of this fluorescence mechanism remains unconfirmed. Sodalite displays the color property of tenebrescence, a dulling of color when exposed to ultraviolet radiation. The variety known as hackmanite, however, retains its pink color indefinitely. The cause of this color persistence is not known. And small crystals are important too. These four minerals here, malanchoite, bucyite, thalcocite, and cyprianite, are all on the order of millimeters, but still, these represent some of the best formed crystals of these species. At the Canadian Museum of Nature, the Hainaut Mont-Saint-Hilaire collection will inspire the public with its beauty and mineral diversity while providing research and training opportunities far into the future. Thank you very much.